Hello, this is Lazarus at Telecom Tech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Ever wonder why the most common subnet mask that you see for IPv4 addresses is 255.255.255.0? Expressed in slash format, that's slash 24. Now, why is that? Well, it all comes down to how IPv4 is designed. An IPv4 address is really a 32-bit binary number. So a network device sees something like this when it views an IP address. Now, because we humans find it very difficult to deal with such notations, we use what is known as the dotted decimal format for IPv4 addresses. So this address looks something like this in dotted decimal format. That's much easier, isn't it? And actually, this address is quite recognizable. Now, IPv4 is designed to be hierarchical in nature. Now, what that means is that addresses are subdivided into subnets, which are essentially subsets of the full range of IPv4 addresses. These subnets are then used by particular LANs or network segments. Now, when we have an IP address, it's accompanied by a subnet mask, and that mask essentially tells us the size of the subnet, or the size of the subset of addresses. Let's take a look again at our IP address in binary format, but this time let's add in the dots where they appear in the dotted decimal format. Now notice that the dots separate the 32-bit number into 8-bit sections. That's one of the reasons why we call them octets. Now, a subnet mask of 255.255.255.0 just happens to separate the IP address into its network and host portions right at the last dot. So let's add our subnet mask here in binary format. Now remember, in all positions where we see a zero, we have the freedom to put in any value. It's the last 8 bits that have zeros, so those last 8 bits of our address within our subnet can range anywhere from all zeros all the way up to all ones. Now, in dotted decimal format, if we look at those addresses, we'll see that the range actually ranges from 192.168.3.0 all the way up to 192.168.3.255. So simply put, the slash 24 subnet makes our lives as humans much easier by providing us with a subnet that can be easily defined by values for the last octet ranging from 0 to 255. So by using such a subnet mask, you avoid the sometimes complex subnetting calculations that are often needed to determine the ranges offered by other subnet masks. Now, in contrast, let's see what we would get if we used another subnet mask, say 255.255.255.128. Now, this subnet mask tells us that it's the last 7 bits that are used within our particular subnet. That means that we can have addresses ranging from the last 7 bits being 0 all the way up to the last 7 bits being 1s. Now notice that it's only the last 7 bits that change, and the rest of the address remains the same. So if we look at these addresses in dotted decimal format, we'll see that the actual range is from 192.168.3.0 all the way up to 192.168.3.127. Now that's not as intuitive, is it? Now just to get the point across, let's say that we have an address of 192.168.3.64 with a subnet mask of 255.255.255.224. If we use that, our subnet would range from 192.168.3.64 all the way up to 192.168.3.93. Now again, that's much more difficult to deal with because the range is not so intuitive. So that is why 255.255.255.0 is the most common subnet mask that we encounter, simply because it's the easiest to manage when it comes to producing an IP address scheme within your enterprise network. In other words, that subnet mask allows us to align the border between the network and host portions exactly at that last dot. Now, what about if we want to align with other dots? There are more dots in the dotted decimal format, and if we choose to, we can set our subnet masks to align with those dots as well. So for example, we can look at the 10.10.0.0 address, and we can use a subnet mask of 255.255.0.0. And there, it's the last 16 bits that are used for host addresses. Similarly, a subnet mask of 255.0.0.0 can also be used to align with the first dot in the IPv4 address. However, these subnet masks are not as useful because they create subnets with thousands and sometimes millions of host addresses respectively, and that's not very efficient. Now, there's just one more thing I'd like to add before we end off, and that's that we use a /24 subnet mask typically when we are deploying addresses in the private IPv4 address range. Now, public IPv4 addresses are provided usually with much smaller subnet masks simply because there aren't that many left. Indeed, getting a /24 IPv4 subnet of public addresses is almost impossible today, and it will become increasingly prohibitive in the future as we move towards IPv6. So that's why the 255.255.255.0 subnet mask is the most commonly used subnet mask within enterprise networks, simply because the mask aligns with that last dot in the dotted decimal format. So the range of our hosts is defined by a value of 0 to 255 in that last octet. Now, network devices couldn't care less what subnet mask is used because they process them in exactly the same way. But it's a matter of convenience for us humans that has led to this development. To find out more about subnet masks, IPv4 addressing, and host and network addresses, take a look at some of my other videos on the channel. If you like this video and you found it useful, please feel free to click the thumbs up button. As well, you can subscribe so that you can be informed of new videos as they are being published. This is Lazarus at Telecom Tech. I hope this video has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.